Here we go, guys. Beautiful banded Kalyun. Yeah, it's a bit dark here now at the moment, but enjoying fishing. Hey guys, this is Wendell Mudli. Welcome to another fishing video. So it is Monday afternoon and we are planning to have another fishing session. So yeah, today I'm not fishing alone, but my uncle's with me. And we're about to go take a drive now to the bluff stretch and start our session there. So as you can see, it's getting dark quite quickly here. And yeah, we've come out to our usual spot on the bluff stretch. And we're here for an afternoon session. So yeah, currently now it's approaching the low tide. And we are about to scratch a little bit on the rocks that's just behind me. But yeah, I'm gonna keep you guys posted and try and record whatever footage I can tonight, even though it'll be dark. But I hope you stay tuned and enjoy today's session. Guys, I got a little crayfish here. So it's amazing how we got hooked. He got hooked on the legs, but a very, very small one. Guys, we're gonna let this one go. Second species, guys, little blacktail.
That's right.
How's the fishing tonight?
Okay, a little bit quiet, eh?
Yeah.
A little bit quiet, but some lot of small blacktails. Getting one, two bites here and there, some pumplets.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's one grey grunt here now.
Lovely, man. Yeah. Yeah, but how's the weather? Weather is nice tonight, eh?
Perfect. Very slight wind, westerly blowing. Water is looking very nice, but only thing, we're not getting the big fish.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the only thing. But there is something, catching something.
Yeah. Well done. Mr. Pumplet. Guys. Beautiful banded Kalyun or Barakal. And yeah, I was starting to doubt because this night was a bit quiet, but very nice size. You can see here's my foot and here's the fish. Beautiful, beautiful banded Kalyun. Chuffed with this. Here we go, guys. Beautiful banded Kalyun. Yeah, it's a bit dark here now at the moment, but enjoying fishing. Oh! Yeah, he's a nice size. Very nice size. Good fight. Yeah. As for the condition tonight, it's not that great, to be honest with you. We came here, the weather's actually pretty good. The wind is not too bad. But the bites were really slow. Just a few small blacktails were coming out, but we persisted. And yeah, my uncle suggested that we move to another spot. And yeah, I came first throw here. Managed to get a banded Kalyun. But yeah, as far as the fishing goes, we're gonna continue to persist. If anything else happens, we'll keep you posted. Thanks. Hey guys, so we're in our third spot tonight. Fishing was quiet tonight for a good while until we came to this spot. And on my first throw, I managed that beautiful banded Kalyun. But with regards to the conditions tonight, it's actually a very beautiful evening. For fishing. There's a slight southwesterly that's blowing, but yeah, as far as the water is actually very good. There isn't really an undercurrent tonight, so the sinker is standing, but it's just that the fish are a little bit quiet, so not sure why they're not feeding tonight. But yeah, other than that, it's a beautiful evening, and we're gonna continue to persist here. I'm actually fishing with my small outfit tonight. Anyway guys, that does it for our session tonight. It was a good evening of fishing, just that the fishing was a little bit slow. We had fish in three different spots actually, just to be able to find the fish. But yeah, walked along the beach and eventually we found the fish. But as far as the conditions go, it was a beautiful evening for fishing. Just a slight southwesterly that was blowing, but the water was actually playing very good today. Just that the fish were a little bit slow in terms of the bites. But yeah, we managed to get a couple of different species tonight, so some blacktails, pumplets, and I managed to get that good size banded Kalyun. Thank you for tuning in today. And
hey guys, I wanted to take a few minutes to talk about a specific species that we catch on the channel specifically, and that is none other than the banded Kalyun, or the nickname for it being Buttercup. Now, you would have seen in today's video that I was rewarded with a very nice size banded Kalyun or Buttercup after we were actually struggling to find the fish. And the reason why I want to talk about targeting this specific fish, especially if you are new to fishing or you may be a little bit more experienced but you want some tips and tricks in terms of knowing how to catch or how to specifically target the banded Kalyun, especially on the coast of KZN. So some interesting facts about this fish. So it is actually closely associated to our national fish, which is the Kalyun. But the banded Kalyun is just a little bit different. And one of the noticeable differences, if you look at it, is that it has actual bands running. So there's one thick band and one thin band. And that's actually what distinguishes it from the national fish, which is the Kalyun. But about the banded Kalyun specifically, now we fish on the bluff stretch area. So if you look at the beaches that run through there, which is Treasure Beach, Anstey's, then you have Sloan's, and then you also have West. So along that stretch of coastline, it's quite well known, you know, by anglers to be able to target these types of rock species. And so you have your bronze bream, you have your banded Kalyun, you have your blacktail, and you have just a whole host of rockfish that feed, especially during the winter months, going towards, you know, the middle and the latter parts of the year. And so specifically with the banded Kalyun, it's a little bit more tricky to target than, for example, like a blacktail, or if you were targeting, you know, some other rock species. And that's because of a few factors. So number one, if you would look at the banded Kalyun, you would notice that its mouth is actually very small as compared to a blacktail or another fish species. And so with that, and you know, you look at how they feed on the bait, they're actually very shy feeders. And so a lot of times anglers actually miss catching buttercups or banded Kalyun because they do not know the specific style that's needed to be able to land it, you know. And so I want to speak about that a little bit today, and specifically the hooks that I have found that work pretty well is your number five. So your number five hooks or your number four. So a lot of times the banded Kalyun will come and they'll inquire, and you know, you might feel a few nibbles and it actually feels like a small fish. And then sometimes they will actually, after a while, swallow the bait and swim front so the line goes slack. And you know, that's the time where, you know, if you're not quick enough, he'll be able to clean off your hook very fast. So you need to be able to know specific strategies in catching them. And for me, what's worked best is to be able to really monitor and give the fish a good chance to eat the bait first. And so, like I said, with its small mouth, it does take a little bit of time maybe for the fish to swallow. But once it has swallowed the bait, that's the time that you're able to set the J-hook, if you're using a J-hook. Most of the times when I catch a banded Kalyun, we are using J-hooks. So that's something to keep in mind. And you know, sometimes it is tricky because it takes the bait and it swims front, and you know, if you're not fast enough, you're not going to be able to set the hook, or it just nibbles and nibbles, and you know, if you try and set the hook too early, you're going to miss the fish. So the timing of it is very crucial. And another reason why I enjoy the banded Kalyun so much is actually because of my grandfather. And many of you know that, you know, I have told the story of my grandfather on this channel, and you know, how he's contributed to my fishing journey and taught me everything that, you know, he knew, him being a master fisherman. But something interesting about him is that if you were to talk to him, and he's caught a lot of species in his lifetime, you know, being an all-round angler, You know, if you were to ask him, you know, what was his favorite fish to eat, actually, he would tell you that it was the banded culleon or the buttercup. And that goes for a lot of fishermen out there, even the subsistence fishermen or fisher folk, you know, that would speak specifically about the taste of the banded culleon. Even I myself enjoy eating a banded culleon because it is a very fatty flesh. It has a very unique taste, especially the skin. And so, that would fried with some butter bread is actually perfect. So, you know, if you want to try targeting this fish, if you maybe don't have a lot of experience targeting banded culleon, or you're more experienced and you want to know a little bit more of tips and tricks, I will be able to share some with you. And, you know, specifically when it comes to looking for structure for them, banded culleon likes to hang out in reefs and very rocky structure. So a lot of times when I'm targeting them, I will fish with a hook snoot that is a little bit longer than my sinker. And also I make a small granny knot at the sinker. So if the sinker gets stuck, especially in very foul areas, I'm able to break off and I'm not going to lose the fish. I will lose the sinker, but the fish will be able to still be on. And case in point, in the fish that I caught in this video, when I reeled the fish out, I realized that my sinker had broken off. So that's one of the reasons I do make that granny knot by the sinker. Now, I did make a trace tutorial last year, so I'll leave a link of that in the description. But something else that, you know, I didn't show in that video is specifically when you are targeting fish on the low tide. And it's important, guys, to be able to read the water. So if it's a high tide, you'll be able to use a high trace. In other words, your sinker is going to be longer at the bottom and your hooks could be at the top. But if you're targeting fish on the low tide, sometimes what I would do is allow my hook snoot to be longer than my sinker snoot, so that, you know, your trace is conducive to the water levels and specifically the rock and gully fishing. Now, when it comes to bait, what works for me the best is using sand prawn, or to be able to use a red bait. Red bait is also, you know, something that you can get off the rocks, but you need to have a license for that. And yeah, you know, those stink baits as well work very, very well. But for me, I found most of my success with targeting banded culleon with sand prawn or cracker. And they feed during the day. They also feed during the night. So, you know, there isn't, you know, specific times for them. But usually, you know, the structure is what's most important. Hey guys, so I just wanted to say thank you so much for all of your support on the channel. Thank you for all of your comments. I do read all of those. And, you know, I also have realized as well that not everyone that tunes into the videos are expert anglers. Some are beginner anglers, or some have maybe never even fished before. And so I also want to bring you content that's engaging and that's also helpful, some tips and tricks, you know, so that, you know, you would be successful when you actually go out fishing, or if you are hungry to target a specific fish. You know, I hope you would be able to find some tips from this video. And so I will be catering a little bit more to that. So if there's any other fish that you would like me to do a tutorial on, that you see that we catch on the channel, and you want some advice about that, please mention that in the comments, and I'll see if I'm able to do a video on that, or just to share some tips and tricks with you. So thank you so much for all of your support, and don't forget, guys, smash that like button, share this video, and subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed already. And we'll catch you on the next one. So take care.